praise the Lord and greetings in the precious name of Jesus. We just want to thank and praise God for all that he's done and all that he's going to do. And we just love the Lord on today for all his many wonderful blessings. We thank God for last night's lying down and for this morning's rising up. We thank God for giving us a portion of health and strength and having activities of our limbs. We just thank God for just putting it in our hearts and our minds to want to come to the house of God for another worship service on this Sunday morning. I am Elder Damon Blissett, and this is Blessed Ministries. Amen. We just thank God for each and every one of you that are here in person, for each and every one that is watching via our live stream on this morning. We just love the Lord and all that he's done for us. And we would like to say happy Palm Sunday to each and every one on today. We're going to get started with our worship service on today. We're going to have an opening selection, and then we're going to have Lady Blissett to come with our scripture, and then we'll have prayer. And then we'll have our second selection, and then we'll move forward into our sermon for today. So we just thank and praise God for all that he's done and all he's going to do. And we pray that God will truly bless you on this day. So we're going to get started with our opening selection. Amen. And this selection is entitled Hosanna. And actually, our second selection, which is a different one, will have the same title. But this song is entitled Hosanna.
Somebody screaming your hands in the house. Clap your hands in the house. Ooh, yeah. Come on, do y'all feel this? I feel this key change coming right here. Sit down, Holy Shadow. Hallelujah.
Amen. We thank God for that opening selection entitled Hosanna. Amen. We're going to go right into our morning scripture on this morning, and we're going to ask Lady Blessed if she would come with our morning scripture. Let us say praise the Lord as she comes.
Praise the Lord and good morning to everyone. Our scripture on this morning will be coming from St. Mark, the 11th chapter, 1 through 10. And when they came nigh to Jerusalem and to Bethage and Bethany and at the Mount of Olives, he sendeth forth two of his disciples and saith unto them, Go your way into the village over against you, and as soon as ye be entered into it, ye shall find a colt tied, whereon never man sat. Loose him and bring him. And if any man say unto you, Why do ye this? Say ye that the Lord has need of him, and straightway he will send him hither. And they went their way and found the colt tied by the door, without in place where two ways met, and they loose him. And certain of them that stood there said unto them, What do ye, loosing the colt? And they said unto them, Even as Jesus had commanded, and they let them go. And they brought the colt to Jesus, and cast their garments on him, and he sat upon him. And many spread their garments in the way, and others cut down branches off the trees, and strawed them in the way. And they that went before, and they that followed cried, saying, Hosanna, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Blessed be the kingdom of our father David that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. May the Lord add a blessing to the readers, hearers, and doers of his word. And at this time, I turn it back into the hands of Elder Damon Blissett. Let's greet him with a hearty praise the Lord.
Scripture reading on this morning. Amen. It is prayer time, and the Bible says that man should always pray and not faint. So we want to give glory and honor to God on this day. For whatever it is that is in your hearts and your minds, let us take that you desire the Lord to move on your behalf. Let us take it before the Lord in prayer. Let us pray. Pray with me. Father God, in the precious name of Jesus, Lord God, our God, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. Lord, we love you, we praise you, we magnify you for all your many wonderful blessings you have bestowed upon us, O God. We thank you, O God, for you just being with us, O God. We thank you for your keeping power, O God. Lord, we thank you, O God, for you just being with us throughout this week from last Sunday to this Sunday, O God. We thank you, O God, for just being with us in this worship service on this morning. And Lord, we ask, Lord, just bless each and everyone that's here, O God. Bless, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Bless each and everyone watching via our live stream. And Lord, we just love you, we praise you, we glorify you right now in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord. Keep us, O God, in these last and evil days, O God. Be with us, give us strength, encourage us, O God. Lift us up, O God. And Lord, we know you are just a mighty God, Lord. And Lord, we know that you're God alone and that you reign and have dominion and power over all things, O God. We thank you, Lord, for you have died on the cross and shed your blood for the remissions of our sins, that we may live and have everlasting life with you, O God. And Lord, we just love you and we thank you, O God. We praise you, O God, for all that you've done. We ask that you bless each and every one, O God, in whatever situation or circumstances they may be in, O God. Just bless and move in a mighty way, O God. Those that are oppressed and depressed, O God. Those that are dealing with mental illnesses, O God, or whatever it may be, O God. Stress right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Those that are sick and shut in, O God, bless those that are sick in their body. Wherever the infirmity may be, O God, Lord, we ask you to just bless and heal right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And Lord, we ask, Lord, you just bless all those that are dealing with issues in the area of finances. Lord, we know that you're a provider and a way maker, O God. And we know that you are able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we can ever ask or think, O God. And Lord, we ask that you just continue to bless, Lord, me and my family as individuals as well as a unit, O God. Touch, O God. Bless us, O God, naturally and spiritually so, O God. Bless this ministry and this platform that we have, O God, that we may continue to do your will, presenting your great gospel, O God, that people may have the opportunity to hear of you and learn of you and to be saved. Right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we just love and we thank you, O God. Continue to bless us, O God, wherever we may be, O God, that we may continue to be a lighthouse in our communities, O God, that people may come running and inquiring of you, that they may be saved, O God. Bless us wherever we may be in our workplaces, O God, in our homes, O God, wherever we may be, out in the stores and traveling around about. Keep your hands in protection and count around about us, O God. Allow us to be a living witness, O God, in a mighty way, O God. Lord, we just love you. We praise you. We ask you to bless leadership naturally and spiritually so. Allow us to make the right decisions in the positions that we're in. And Lord, we thank you. We praise you. We glorify and magnify your holy name, O God. Bless each and every listener, O God. Bless each and everyone I've been in contact with, oh God, and via social media, oh God, in other areas that have inquired, oh God, about you, oh God. And Lord, we just thank you, we praise you, we glorify you, oh God. Give me the words to say, oh God, to encourage them, oh God, to continue to seek after you. And we just love you, we praise you, we magnify you. We give you all the glory, honor, and praise. And in Jesus' name we pray, let every heart say amen. And we just thank and praise God for all that he's done. Amen. And we're going to move forward on this in our service and go to our second selection. Again, you may see there's a theme on today, of course, with this being Palm Sunday. Amen. This song is also entitled Hosanna.
Let me hear you make some Holy Ghost crazy noise right now. Let me hear. Come on. Come on, Zion. Clap those hands with me. Come on, come on. All God's people. Come on, come on, Mike. Like this, come on. Here we go.
Angels.
Amen. We thank God for that second selection there. Amen. We just love the Lord and all that he's done for us and all that he's going to do. And we just thank and praise God for all his many wonderful blessings on this morning. Amen. I am Elder Damon Blissett, and this is Blessed Ministries. And we just thank and praise God for each and every one again that is here in person, for each and every one that is watching and listening via our live stream on this morning. We want to thank and praise God for each and every one of you. And we thank and praise God for allowing us to see another Palm Sunday on today. And we just thank and praise God for all his many wonderful blessings. And for you, those of you that have been here watching from the beginning, you should see the theme of today. Amen. For this Palm Sunday, we're going to be talking about Hosanna. Amen. On this day. So we just love the Lord and all his many wonderful blessings. I ask that you like the video, amen, and subscribe to our channel, if you will. And we ask that you also share this to your social media pages, amen, and let everyone in your family and your friends know what Blessed Ministries is doing, amen. Let them know that we're live right now, amen. We're about to go into the Word of God here in just a few minutes on this Palm Sunday. Amen. But we thank and praise God for each and every one that has been supporting us over the last 2+ years in this platform. Amen. As we've been going live each and every Sunday morning. We thank God for all your support and all for all your prayers. But we thank God for each and every one of you that has been supporting us financially. Amen. So it's offering time. Amen. So we thank and praise God for each and every one of you. And I ask that you, with it being offering time, you can give via your tithes, your offering, or love donations at this time. For those of you watching on a video, I have the QR codes for our electronic means of giving. Amen. There are three ways to give. You can give via Cash App, via Zelle, or via Zenmo. Our Cash App is $Blessed Ministries. Our Zelle is blessedministries@gmail.com. And our Venmo is the @ Blessed Ministries. Amen. As again, the QR codes is on the video here. You can just take your camera or your electronic device and just scan it, and it'll take you directly to where you can give on those particular methods. And you can do that at this time, or you can do that at any time that you desire, right now or anytime during this message or even afterwards. All this information is also in the description of the video on our YouTube channel. We also have this YouTube channel that we're on now is under my proper name of Damon Blissett. There is a ministry proper channel. It's just entitled Blessed Ministries. That's Blessed with 2 T's Ministries. Amen. So we thank and praise God and ask that you subscribe to that channel as well. And immediately after we finish this service, we'll upload the video to that particular channel. Amen. If there's any correspondence you desire to have with us, you can do that via our email address. That email address is, of course, blessedministries@gmail.com. blessedministries@gmail.com. So we thank and praise God for each and every one of you, amen, that have desire to give, amen, to this ministry via your love offerings, tithing, and love donations. We just thank God for each and every one of you. It allows us to carry on the ministry, amen, in different methods. It allows us to continue to have proper and good technology, amen, for this live stream, as well as to do other ministry activities that's that we do outside the doors, amen, the walls of the church, amen, that we can go into the community and do other things, amen. So we thank and praise God for each and every one of you, amen. I just love the Lord and all that he's done for me, and I'm excited on today, amen, that we can continue to praise and magnify the name of the Lord, amen. So I believe there's nothing else to state beyond that at this time, so we're going to direct ourselves to the Word of God. So we're going to go to the book of Matthew, chapter 21, and read verses 1 through 11. Matthew 21, verses 1 through 11. I'm coming from the King James Version or translation. And as I always state, I encourage everyone to take notes during our messages that we deliver each week. Write down the scripture and the subject or title of the topic of the day, Amen. And any other scriptures or definitions or any thoughts that you hear, please write those down. That way you can go back afterwards and read, pray, and meditate on it and see what God has for you. Amen. So we're going to go to Matthew chapter 21 and read verses, start at verse 1 and read down through verse 11. And it reads, "And when they drew nigh unto Jerusalem, and were come to Bethphage, and unto the Mount of Olives, then sent Jesus two disciples, saying unto them, Go into the village over against you, and straightway ye shall find an ass tied, and a colt with her. Loose them, and bring them unto me. And if any man say aught unto you, ye shall say, The Lord hath need of them, and straightway he will send them." Verse 4 says, "All this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, saying, Tell ye the daughters of Zion, Behold, the king cometh unto thee, meek and sitting upon an ass, and a colt the foal of an ass. And the disciple went and did as Jesus commanded them, and brought the ass and the colt, and put on them their clothes, and they set him thereon. And a very great multitude spread their garments in the way. Others cut down branches from the trees and strew them in the way. And the multitude that went before and that followed cried, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And when he was come into Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, Who is this? And verse 11 concludes, says, And the multitude said, This is Jesus, the prophet of Nazareth of Galilee. Amen. May God add a blessing to the reading and hearing and doing of his word. Let us bless the word with prayer. Father God, in the precious name of Jesus, we thank you, we praise you, we magnify, glorify your holy name, for you alone are worthy of all the glory, honor, and praise. We just love you on today and ask that you just continue to bless this service on this morning, oh God. Bless each and everyone that's here and each and every watcher and listener via the live stream, whether right now or those that view it later, oh God. Bless them and touch them in a mighty way. Help encourage them, oh God. And I ask that you increase as I decrease, oh God. And Lord, I ask you that you give me clarity of thought that I may be able to speak with understanding. And Lord, I love you. We praise you. We magnify and glorify you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Let every heart say amen. Amen. So Matthew chapter 21, verses 1 through 11 is where we just read. And our title today, of course, you should already pick that up, is just Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna is the title of our lesson on today. Amen. Amen. So those of you that are regular watchers and viewers and those that are here, regular attenders of our worship services each and every week, amen. You may have found or heard, of course, I keep mentioning it, the theme that we've been speaking and teaching on here or a common theme, not necessarily the subject of each and every message, but a theme or a thing I'm emphasizing, have been emphasizing, is repentance, repenting, repentance. Amen. That's where it's just what's been in my heart and my mind here. In the last several months, as we examine our world and examine the state of the church and the state of Christianity, and the sole purpose of ministry is to get twofold: one, to bring all mankind to a point of repentance, And two, of course, once we come, have repented, amen, and met the criteria that is laid out in Acts 2 and 38, and we received the Holy Ghost, and then is to work on our soul salvation, to grow in faith, to grow in God, to become stronger, amen, to be to know God's word and to walk according to it, amen. And that has just been in my heart that now that we are in the last, as we say, the last days, but we're in the last of the last of the last days, if you're one that know the scripture and you're being observant to the signs of the time in this world and our society and how the division is there, amen, in all things, even in the church, amen, there is division and laying down of the foundation of the doctrine, with setting it aside to appease people, to keep the numbers up and to keep the dollars flowing, amen, and we're forgetting about the sole purpose, which is the soul. Amen, amen, putting that first, amen, and all the other things will come after, amen. That's why the Bible says, amen, I believe Jesus stated, it says, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all the other things will God will take care of those things. So if we put God's business first, amen, we do have to do work for those other things. It does take finances to run ministry, amen, and we want to make sure that we have the things in place, amen, to satisfy, not necessarily satisfy, but to keep people, have the things in place for people, amen. We can't have a full church, full building, and then there's no air conditioning. It'll be hot in there. People will leave, amen. So it does take finances and things like that to have, amen, the things for allow the church services and things to go on and other ministry things, amen, to allow people to be able to grow, amen. But my emphasis that I'm seeing, amen, for even those that have been in church for even as long as I have, is that people are falling away. They're still coming to church, amen, but their faith is waning, amen. Their strength and their power is lacking, amen. Their motivation is suffering, amen. And we just need to come to a place where we go back to the place where we started from and regain the joy, amen, that we received when we first were filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost, amen, that fire that kindled in our spirit, amen, that we could not wait to get to the house of God to be able to share what God has done through us, with us, and throughout the week, amen, to share and just come and touch and agree that we not only I can praise God, but I can magnify the name of the Lord, amen, all of us together. We can magnify God and be encouraged from your testimony and my testimony and this other person's testimony, just sharing the goodness of God and all that he has done in our lives. Amen. So let us try and turn our way to this particular lesson on today, on this Palm Sunday. Amen. This particular event here, amen, we came from Matthew 21. Each of the four Gospels in the Bible makes mention of that, if at least at a minimum or as a totality, as this one did, kind of laid out the whole story here, at least it's the beginning part. And this is this day, we call it Palm Sunday, but it's also known as the triumphal entry of Jesus Christ, amen, going into Jerusalem. Going into Jerusalem, this day is also known as the first day of what is called, some call Passion Week, or some call Holy Week, amen, because we know on next Sunday is what? Resurrection Sunday. So this is the start of the events that led to Jesus being, amen, sent before the high priest and then before Pontius Pilate and all the events that led to the crucifixion of Jesus Christ, amen, him dying on the cross and then later rising up, amen, with all power in his hand, amen. So we serve a true and what? Living God, amen. The God that we serve is not dead, but he is yet alive, amen. So at this time, and after Jesus has been around and has gone around teaching and performing miracles, amen, now it is time. He's been in ministry for three years or more, amen, at this time, and now it's time for, amen, the final prophecies to fulfill itself. So now it's time for what Jesus to go into Jerusalem, amen, where the temple is, where the synagogue is, where the high council is, amen. And this is known as Jesus taking his position, amen. That's why it's called triumphal entry, where he is going, amen, into Jerusalem to show himself to God's chosen people, Israel, amen, that he is the Messiah that the prophecies have been talking about. Amen. So let me get back to my notes so I don't skip anything and get to that. Amen. As I was stating, all four of these evangelists talking about the four gospels take notice of the passage of Christ riding in triumph into Jerusalem 5 days before his death. Amen. For those who are taking notes, of course, we just read, had Lady Blissett, she read Mark 11, 1 through 10. Amen. And of course, our core scripture today is Matthew 21, 1 through 11. But this is also found in Luke chapter 19, verses 28 through 38. And then John makes mention of this in chapter 12, verses 12 through 15. Amen. That way, when you go back and study it, you can see how they all introduce this or present this. And as I stated, amen, this is known as the triumphal entry, amen, to be triumphant, amen. From a definition standpoint, it means having won a battle or contest or being victorious, feeling or expressing jubilation after having won a victory or mastered a difficulty. Let's say that again. Having won a battle or contest, being victorious, amen. We're talking about triumphant, feeling or expressing jubilation after having won a victory or mastered a difficulty. Amen. Don't we all want to do that, be triumphant or be victorious? Amen. Some of us are in school and we get that degree. Amen. That means we're conquered the lessons and the questions and the tests that we had in our classes. Some of us may go and are on our jobs and go get certified for certain things, and we go and take the class, and then we perform the activity, and we show that we've mastered it, so that now we are victorious. Amen. As that last part said, it said master the difficulty. Amen. Some of us are in our younger days when we had to take our driver's test. We had to learn and take the written and the driving test, and it may be difficult at first, but then we mastered that skill and passed the test, and now we're licensed. Amen. We're a licensed driver. That means we're permitted to drive. We're victorious. Amen. And there may be some of us that may have other difficulties in our lives. Amen. We may have had drug problems, amen, and then we are victorious over that, that we're able to get rid of drugs or have other things going on in our personal lives, or even in this time, amen, we're now in April, amen, but we're now in the concluding portion of, for those of you that like sports, of having March Madness, and we have all with the basketball tournament at the college level, and even at the high school levels, these things are going on, the tournaments are going on, and all the teams are striving for what? To be victorious, to become what? A champion in that sport, amen, in that particular league that they're in, amen. So there are challenges and difficulties, and we must press through, amen, in order to get the victory, amen. So now Jesus is at the point where, amen, he is leading into the point where the final or the ultimate victory will take place when? Amen. On Resurrection Sunday. Amen. But first, he must make his final notification saying that I'm here. Amen. And that I am your Messiah. And he's coming to his people that he came from. Amen. Back to my notes proceed forward. It says this event is traditionally known as the triumphal entry, which we've been just stated, when Jesus officially offers himself to the nation of Israel as her long-awaited Messiah. However, in many ways, it was far from a triumph, for the day ended in Jesus' public prediction of his rejection by his own people. Amen. So Jesus had to press through, amen, in a time where you should be celebrated, amen. He ended up being demised, if you will. He ended up being rejected, amen. You are not my king. You are not my champion, amen. You are not the one that we're looking for, amen, to be our leader and king. Now, now at this point, it says Bethphage Bethphage was a village near Bethany, about 6 miles east of Jerusalem, and apparently hidden from it by the summit of the Mount of Olives, which was the hill on the east of Jerusalem. When I was reading a commentary, it was saying, it described it as those villages as being like a suburb to a city. Amen. It's like a suburb to a city. And of course, Jerusalem being next to the Mount of Olives, that is, it was kind of hidden away from the city. It was kind of separated. You could say it was a suburb of the city, but there was a mountain that was in between there, and you had to go around that for a journey in order to get into the city from those particular suburbs or villages in this case. And now, let's go back to here, the scripture. It says, now, and when they drew nigh into Jerusalem and were come to Bethphage and the Mount of Olives, then sent Jesus two disciples. So Jesus sent two disciples, and he said this. To my notes here, it said, in commentary when I was reading, it said they think it was Peter and John were the two disciples. Amen. It's not listed in any of those scriptures that I noted there, but in commentary I was reading, they believed it was Peter and John were the two that were sent. Just for some information for your notes. Now it says, saying unto them, go into the village over against you, and straightway ye shall find an ass tied and a colt with her. Loose them and bring them unto me. And if any man say aught unto you, ye shall say, the Lord had need of them, and straightway he will send them. Amen. So that was the instructions that Jesus gave unto them, because this was also part of the prophecy that was needed in order to take place and to be fulfilled. And you can find that in Zechariah chapter 9 and verse 9. Amen. So if you write that down, and we can read that real quick and move forward. It says, Zechariah chapter 9 and verse 9. It says, rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion, shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, the king cometh unto thee. He is just and having salvation, lowly, and riding upon an ass and upon a colt, the foal of an ass. Amen. So this was another fulfillment of the prophecy of how Jesus or the Messiah was to come and introduce him or show himself to his people in Israel. In Israel. Amen. So this was all still part of the prophecies. All these steps must take place for the prophecies to be fulfilled, to show and illustrate that Jesus is what? Our Messiah, our King, our partner of our sin. Amen. So it says here, it says, when Christ would appear in his glory, It is in his meekness, not in his majesty, in mercy to work salvation. What is most significant is that Jesus chose a humble animal to ride into the city, not a mighty war horse with sinewy muscles of great mass and strength, leading a procession of highly trained warriors armed with breastplates of brass and plans for battle. So Jesus rode on a donkey or ass, a symbol of humility. But the presence of the king on a donkey did not keep the people from praising him. They perceived the prophet among them and greeted him as king. So as we read forward here, we're at verse 4. It says, all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, saying, verse 5 says, tell ye the daughter of Zion, behold, the king cometh unto thee, meek and sitting upon an ass, and a colt the foal of an ass, which was the scripture I just read, Zechariah chapter 9. And verse 9 says, and the disciples went and did as Jesus commanded them, verse 7, and brought the ass and the colt and put them there, their clothes, and they set him upon. And a very great multitude spread their garment in the way. Others cut down branches from the trees and strewed them in the way. And the multitude that went before, let me stop right there before I go forward further in that. It said, as we talked about, now it's just talking about how Jesus, as we just described, how the way Jesus came, amen. He didn't come, he came in a form of being humility, it says, a lowly way. He didn't come in as a mighty king, which was the way they were expecting. Amen. Because Israel were under the taxation of the Roman Empire and was being suppressed and overtaxed and all this. That's why they didn't like the tax collectors, which, of course, this writer here in the book of Matthew was one of those. And but he was chosen by God, amen, to be one of his disciples. Amen. So they were looking for someone that's not necessarily to be their Messiah in the manner of our partner of our sins in terms of salvation, but they just wanted someone to come, amen, and get rid of the Roman Empire so they can reign and conduct their lives as they could, amen, and be able to be prosperous and move forward, amen, in their lives. That's what they were expecting, but he didn't come in that manner. But even as he came on this donkey into the city, amen, the people, as it said here, they discerned what? They discerned that he was the king, amen, that he was the Messiah. He was the one, amen, that came, amen, to give them, amen, victory in their lives, because many of them have already seen the miracles, signs, and wonders that he performed and sat up under him and as he was teaching the disciples and going throughout the land, and they've known of the ministry that he was performing. So we thank God, amen, that they recognize this here, amen. And as I continue on in my notes here, as we move forward, it says, when Jehu was proclaimed king, and said the captains put their garments upon him in taking of their subjection of him. As we was reading here, as they brought the colt to him, it said what? That they put garments on the horse, amen, or the donkey or the animal there, amen. That was to give some comfort as opposed to riding a horse bareback, if you will, amen. That is one example there. But as it moves forward, it says those that take Christ for their king must lay there all under their feet. We must lay it all under his feet. It says the clothes and the taking of their heart. For when Christ comes, though not even when anyone else comes, it must be said to the soul, bow down, that he may go over. Amen. So as we see Christ come in our lives, we must take a humble position and bow down to worship him. When Christ comes in our lives, we must come under subjection to his authority as being God. So let me say that again. When Jesus comes into our lives, we must bow down and worship him, recognizing him as being the authority in our lives. So Jesus is coming, amen, triumphant, amen, because he's about to take proclaim victory over our lives, amen, in spite of what all Satan is doing in our lives, all the things that are in our mind, and as we examine our lives and we do not like the things, we have dreams that are falling short, and all the things that we do not like, the goals and dreams that we may have failed at, amen, but God has come to give us victory, amen, to lift up our bowed down heads and to wipe the tears from our lives, because why? First, he's going to take, amen, and save our souls if we do what? Praise and acknowledge him as being our Lord and Savior in our lives. So these individuals, amen, as I said here, let me go back to verse 8. It says, a very great multitude spread their garments in the way, amen, and others cut down branches from trees and strew them in the way. So it says, for those that take Christ for their king, so those of us that accept Christ as our king, we must lay all under his feet. Amen. We must lay it all, present it all. Amen. We say, take our burdens to the Lord and what? And lead them there. We must let God to rise upon it in our clothes and in the token of our hearts. For when Christ comes, though not when anyone else comes, it must be said to the soul, bow down that they may go over. So some think that these garments were spread not upon the ground, but upon the hedges or the walls to adorn the roads as to beautify the cavalcade, the balconies are hung with tapestry. When I was reading that again last night, I thought about, if you think about in movies, and when we look at places like India or even Brazil or something like that, and some of the lower what we may consider second or third world countries, and you look at the how close to how the housings are and how they have the cloth, the colored cloths going from one side to the other side of the walkways. Amen. They were laying a path to beautify. Amen. Because why? Because the king is coming. Amen. So they were laying their cloths, their garments was putting out their cloths to beautify the path that he was coming. Because you think about it, the trail that he was coming is a dirt path. Amen. So it'd be depending on the time of the year, it can be dusty or muddy and dirty. Amen. But it was they knew the king was coming. So they're trying to beautify the path. Amen. That the king was taking going to take. Amen. To come into their lives. Amen. To give them victory over all things. It says others cut down branches from trees and strew them in the way as they used to do at the Feast of Tabernacles in token of liberty, victory, and joy. Amen. So these trees were considered, were thought to be palm trees, palms. And palms or branches are usually symbols of victory and overcoming hardship. Amen. Let's say that again. Palms were known, amen, as branches that symbolizes victory. Amen. So when they saw the king coming, the Messiah, they knew they were about to have victory over their situation. Amen. So if we look at Leviticus chapter 23 in verse 40, let's say that again, Leviticus chapter 23 and verse 40. You can write that down. And it reads, it says, "And ye shall take you on the first day the boughs of goodly trees, branches of palm trees, and the boughs of thick trees, and the willows of the brook, and ye shall rejoice before the Lord your God 7 days." That was Leviticus 23 that signifies about the palm trees, about the palms, amen, about the branches that they cut down and lay before him because it was signifying victory, amen. When you see the kingdom come, come in your life, when you see Christ come in your life, if I say it better, amen. If we see Christ come in our lives, we ought to know that victory is coming. If we accept Christ in our lives, we know that victory is coming. Whatever the issues that we're dealing with, if we put Christ in the situation, we know that victory is coming. Amen. Whatever that drug addiction may be, amen. If we put Christ in it, amen, we know we can have victory. Whatever our financial issue may be, if we put Christ in it, we shall have victory. Amen. Whatever our health issue may be, amen. If we put Christ in it, amen, we can have victory. If we just recognize the sin of our lives and we want to get rid of it, if we put Christ in it, amen, put the ingredient of Christ, put the ingredients of the word of God in the midst of it, amen, we shall have victory over the sin that is in our lives, amen. That way we can go from a way of ungodly to a godly position, way of unrighteousness to a way of righteousness, one, amen, so we can be fulfilled, amen, in the victory of Christ. We want to be victorious in our lives, amen. So now we move forward to verse 9 as we begin to come to a close here in just a few minutes, amen. It says, "And the same multitude that went before and that followed cried, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest." Amen. Amen. Who was the highest? The king. Amen. He is the high priest in our lives. Amen. He came, amen, and taught us his word. Amen. Jesus, God came and manifested himself, amen, in the flesh. Amen. That according to John chapter 1 and verse 14 through 17 describes that. Amen. And when we talked about that a few months ago, that particular lesson, it said Jesus, the flesh, amen, the manifestation allowed us to hear vocally, hear and see the teachings of Jesus Christ directly. Amen. We heard from God directly. Amen. So we received the teachings of him. Amen. We heard from God directly, and he told us that he was going to come and die for our sins. Amen. He came and bled and died for our sins. So we recognize him as being the highest. Amen. The high priest. Hosanna to the Son of David. Amen. That's because he came through the lineage of David. Blessed is the is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. So when they saw Jesus coming, they recognized that victory is coming. Somebody ought to be excited on today that when you see Jesus coming into your situation, you ought to know that you are about to be victorious. Amen. Amen. When you for those of us that were athletes, amen, and played in sports, amen, when you saw the best player about to come into the game, you knew you were about to win. Amen. When that person about to come in, amen. When they foul your best player, you know he's going to make the shot. Amen. When the best player's name is called for the play on the football field, you know that he's going to score the touchdown. Amen. You get excited because you know, amen, the game's not even over, but you know victory is at hand. Amen. You're about to win this thing. You're about to win this thing. Amen. When you come into church, you ought to know that God is here. Amen. And I'm about to get the victory over this situation. Amen. So when we come to church, when we come to God, we must be, amen, come to a point in our mind that I am want to give up all, amen, for you. Amen. Let's say that again. When I come to church, I must say, have in my mind that I want to give up all for you. Amen. Because Jesus wants to order our steps, amen, that we can be victorious. Amen. Because the way that I was walking was end up going down the wrong path. Amen. He wants to take us down the straight and narrow that's going to take us, lead us to victory and to salvation and ultimately into heaven and to a relationship with him. Amen. A place, amen, that we were in the garden before the fall where we can fellowship and sup with him. Amen. So Hosanna means, it's a cry, and in definition, it means please save or to save now is a plea for salvation. So when they saw him coming, they said, I need salvation from you, Jesus. Amen. I see you as being the Messiah, our risen King. Amen. That is coming. So let us look at Psalm 118. Psalm 118, our final scripture for today, and then we'll come to a close here in a few minutes. Psalm 118, verses 25 through 26. Amen. While you do that. Amen. Psalm 118, verses 25 and 26. It says, save now. I beseech thee, O Lord, O Lord, I beseech thee, send now prosperity. Blessed be he that cometh in the name of the Lord. We have blessed you out of the house of the Lord. Amen. Save now. When we see Jesus, we want him to save us now. Save us now. Our Hosanna, the title of this lesson, amen. We want God to save us now because we ought to be at a point that I've been emphasizing for the last several weeks and a couple of months. Amen. Because we ought to be at a place of repentance. And when we come to that place, we want God to what? Save us now. Amen. Because I want to be forgiven of my sin. Amen. I recognize, amen, that I've sinned. And as previous lesson, we talked about having a contrite heart. I am sincere and I'm in a place of sincerity, amen, that I want to give up this path, but I can't do it on my own. But now that I see that it's you that I need, I ask that you save me now. Hosanna, save me now. Save me. Order my steps that I can continue in your path. Amen. I do not like this way that I have been going. And I think about the song that Fred Hammond and Commission had years ago saying, I'm running back to you. Amen. We talked about the prodigal son the other week a little bit. The scripture said that he came to his right mind. Amen. And he turned back and went back to what? His father's house. Amen. So we ought to turn back to the house of God when we repent and when we see Jesus, amen, say, Hosanna, please save me now. Now it says here, as we come to a conclusion, it says, Hosanna signifies, save now, we beseech thee, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. But of how little value is the applause of the people? It says, amen, because we read further in here and know the story of what happened in Passion Week, amen, these individuals that were saying, pray, Hosanna, Hosanna, later said, crucify him. Let's say that again. There were many that were in the crowd that said, Hosanna, Hosanna, amen. They weren't fully at a place of true repentance. They weren't at a broken heart that I talked about a few weeks ago. They weren't sincere, amen. So what did they end up doing? They followed the crowd, amen, and said, crucify him. Amen. It says the changing multitude joined the cry of that day, but whether it be Hosanna or later, crucify him. It said the multitudes often seemed to approve the gospel, but few became consistent disciples. It says, when Jesus was come into Jerusalem, all the city was moved. Some perhaps were moved with joy who waited for the consolation of Israel. It says others of the Pharisees, they were moved with envy. Amen. As we talked about, as we went through this lesson, amen, they were not expecting their Messiah, their king, amen, to come in this lowly state. Amen. They was looking for a warrior, amen, basically to just remove the Roman rule over their lives in their city, amen, in the way they conducted their lives, amen. That was all they was wanting, but they weren't looking for, amen, for salvation. But we are teaching here at Blessed Ministries, amen, about salvation, amen, about reconciling ourselves back to God, and about coming to a place of repentance, recognizing that we are in a sinful state, or we have committed an act of sin, amen, and we must repent to God, amen, in order to be reconciled back to him, amen. So we must run back to the church. We must run back to our Savior and say, Hosanna, please save me now, amen, because my sin is going to take me a place of destruction and death, amen. And I do not want to die this death here on earth and then to ultimately die the second death, which is going to send me to the lake of fire. But I want you to say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Amen. Amen. I want you to see favor when you see me. Amen. So that's why, according to Acts 2 and 38, we must repent of our sins. Amen. And then we must be baptized in the name of Jesus. And then we shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. It is a free and promised gift to you according to the scriptures. And according to Acts 1 and 8, when we have the Holy Ghost, we have power over the enemy. Amen. And the Bible says, if we resist, amen, the devil, amen, he shall flee. Amen. So these issues that in life that you may have, yours may be different from mine, but we all have struggles because the Bible says we have all have fallen short, have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. So my hiccup, my hang up may not be yours. Amen. My hang up may not be your hang up. Amen. But I still must repent just like you must repent. There's no big sin, no little sin. There's no big crime or little crime as we see in this modern day. Amen. Thinking that because of whatever position you may be in, amen, that you're above the law. No man is above the law, especially in God's law. Amen. If you have sinned, you will go to the pit. Let me say that again. If you're in sin, when he comes back, you'll be going back to the pit. Going to the pit. Amen. So we encourage you to make this day your day of Pentecost. Amen. And be filled with this precious Holy Ghost that you can have recognize that you're certified victorious. Amen. You are certified victorious because you have the Holy Ghost in your life. Amen. So I thank and praise God that I am saved, sanctified, and filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. I thank God that I have him in my life. Amen. Amen. I may fall short from time to time, but I recognize that I must get back up and get back on the right path. Amen. So I say Hosanna today. Amen. Please save me now. That is the message for today. Amen. Say Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Save me now. Hosanna, save me now. Amen. I pray that you have heard something on today. Amen. That has blessed you. Amen. Hosanna, Hosanna. Amen. Hosanna. Hosanna, save me now. Save me now. Hosanna, save me now. Hosanna, save me now. Amen. I recognize that I'm sin. Amen. Everything I've tried to do, I've fallen short. Amen. I continue to make the same mistakes over and over again, God. Amen. Every time I know to do better, but I keep falling short. Amen. I keep making the same mistakes. I don't know why. Amen. But I keep falling short. Amen. I recognize it is you that I need in my life. Amen. Amen. Jesus, save me now. Save me now. Save me now. Yes, Lord, save me now. Even today, save me now. Lord, we just thank you. Amen. We glorify God. We pray that you've heard something today. Amen. That it helped you, encourage you. Amen. That is Jesus that you need in your lives. Amen. Amen. You know, next week we'll continue on. Amen. To hit the other bookend of this journey. Amen. Where Jesus went on the cross. shed his blood for our sins, amen. For without the shedding of blood, there are what? No remissions of sin. So he had to conclude this act, amen, that we may be saved, amen. The blood has been shed already. Your sins are already forgiven. It's a matter of you accepting it and coming to that place of repentance. Amen. Do that today and do it now. Let it not be said too late. Let it not be said too late. Amen. The Bible says that no man knows the day nor the hour when the Lord shall come back for you. That is twofold. That is either for you individually in death, or that is for us all in the rapture. Amen. We don't know when that day shall come. Amen. But let us be ready. Let us be ready on today. Amen. Make today your day of Pentecost. Repent of your sins on today. Hallelujah. Thank God. Amen. Be baptized in the precious name of Jesus, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. So when the Lord comes back for us, he can say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Amen. That is our desire for today. Amen. That we all work out our soul salvation and continue to grow in God and stronger in him and stronger in our faith. Amen. We just love the Lord for all that he's done. Again, I am Elder Damon Blissett, and this is Blessed Ministries. Amen. We thank God for each and everyone that's here in person and those that are watching via our live stream on this morning. Amen. We pray that you've heard something on today and that God will bless you throughout the remainder of your day. Make today your day of Pentecost. Make today your day of Pentecost. Be filled with this precious Holy Ghost. Amen. We came with a message of titled Hosanna from Matthew 21, verses 1 through 11. Again, we ask that you like the video, subscribe to the channel, share this, amen, to your social media pages. Amen. And let the world know, amen, what is going on with Blessed Ministries and the Word of God that has been said and taken place on today. Amen. I thank God for you. Amen. I thank God for your prayers. Amen. We ask that you continue to pray for us as we pray for you. Amen. Amen. For those that desire to give, you can do that at this time. Amen. You can do that via our Cash App, our Zelle, and our Venmo. All this information is on the screen. It is also in the description on the video. Amen. If you desire to have any correspondence with us, you can do that via our email address. That is blessedministries@gmail.com. That is blessedministries@gmail.com. Amen. For those that are in our locality, amen, we're limited in space, amen, but you're welcome to come. Just contact us, and we'll acknowledge your RSVP for whatever particular Sunday, and we'll try to make accommodations for you. Amen. And but we thank God, amen, our live stream is always there, amen, whether you see it, choose this as your ministry, amen, your place that you want to make your home, please do that. Let us know via our email address that you desire to be a part of this ministry, our virtual ministry here. Amen. We just love God and all that he's going to do for you. Amen. We encourage you, amen, to find God, stay with God. Find him, come back to him, make him first in your life. Amen. So we just thank God for all that he's done and all that he's going to do on today and the remainder of your day. Amen. So we're going to conclude our service with a dismissal prayer. Amen. So let us pray. Father God, in the precious name of Jesus, we thank you, we praise you, oh God. We cry out Hosanna to you on today. We love you, we praise and magnify your holy name. Ask that you bless each and everyone that's here and each and everyone that's watching via our live stream. We love you, we praise you, we magnify you. We give you all the glory, honor, and praise. And in Jesus' name we pray. Let every heart say amen.
I'm to be in the service. My God. If you're glad to be here, put your hand on it like this.